Hey. How are you doing, Facebook? How are you doing? This is an exciting day for me. And I'm your girl, Julie Kalungi, coming at you live from my home here in Liverpool. And today I'm just going to share with you my travel essentials, my carry-on essentials. Those things that keep me looking fresh, looking fabulous, and getting to my destination looking like a million bucks. I bet you want to listen to that stuff. A lot of people don't know what to pack. Seriously, I'm here to help you to get your pack mojo on. I have my goodie bag with me. Look at this. This is my carry-on. That's my carry-on. So I'm going to share with you what's in this bag. Every single thing. As you can see, I've just dropped something. I've already packed for my next trip, and this is trip number 6 of 2017. So this is my 6th trip, and I can't wait because it's gonna be the longest so far. I'm very excited. I'm super excited. I can't wait. What's in my carry-on bag? When I travel, I get excited when I'm going to travel. I get excited when I come from travel. And so what's in my carry-on bag? I'll start with the simple things and the heaviest one of them, because I want to get it out of the way so that it gets out of my bag. I carry that with me every single time. That's my laptop. It is also my business hub. It is also where everything that pertains to my brand is. Now here's something: if you are traveling from some destinations or using certain airlines and you're traveling from or to the UK, this is something you're gonna have to pay attention to. The UK has passed a law whereby you are not allowed to take something like that, your tablet, your computer, laptop, your even chargers, even phone chargers. So I'm showing you some of the things I put in my carry-on. Your phone charger, your charge, any kind of charger, it's not allowed in your carry-on. If you're traveling to or from the UK, it's not allowed in your carry-on. If you're coming from Turkey, if you're coming from any of the Middle East Asian countries, if you're coming from Egypt, so don't put those things in your carry-on if you're using the airlines that, like Turkish Airlines, those airlines coming from those countries, don't. So what else is in my carry-on? I've just shared with you my laptop and the charger. Once I get onto the flight, I pull out my laptop and I start doing things like creating images, things that don't need too much concentration. I create some images, I create some image quotes. I also edit my posts so that I have a whole lot of posts ready for my blog. I get some of my trainings edited and amend some of that stuff and update it. That way my clients and my students have great content. So my laptop is a must-have in my carry-on. Absolutely, don't forget your passport. Don't forget your passport. It's important that you carry your passport with you if you are flying anywhere, even if you're flying to as well. This goes with me everywhere. What is this? Is in my joy journal. This is my joy and gratitude journal. As you can see, it's quite full of gratitude. It's quite full of all the things that I set myself to do every day. And then every day I write down what I'm grateful for and what I've achieved in this journal. This book is gold. It's got my private thoughts. It's got my ideas. It's also my ideas book. I don't go anywhere without it. That goes without saying that I also have a pen right inside of this journal that I carry with me. If you're going to a different country, you probably might have to be filling out some immigration forms, some visa forms, tourist forms. You need a pen. In the same way, you also need a pencil, because sometimes I prefer a pencil. A pen might refuse to work. A pencil will always work. And I always have my sharpener with me. That means I can always sharpen my pencil, so I'm always good to go. My phone goes with me. If you're getting value, do drop a like. Muveyo mkamoli, drop a like. I take my phone with me everywhere. It is also it's the same as my laptop. I can do stuff on my phone. I can use Evernote. I can use notes on my phone to take notes, to grab ideas and note them down so that I remember. I take pictures with my phone so that I can remember. I usually take pictures also for my blogs. So I normally use authentic images for my pictures. So I can't do without my phone. And this is something I take with me. It's not normally in the bag because it will get squashed. But if I'm going to a hot country, I have this with me. And I put it on. How do I look? Yeah. What should I send to you, Edward? I have no idea what you need me to send you. So this is my hat, and I bought it in ASOS, on ASOS, and it is absolutely great. I look great with it. I feel great with it when I put it on, especially when I'm in a hot country. So I absolutely love the hat. If you got going in a hot country, you're gonna be hot. The sun's gonna be burning. I have this hat. Now, if I'm going to a cold country, I'm gonna look chic. And it's gonna cover my head so I don't feel cold. So it does two birds with one stone. This hat has been places. I tell you, I can change it. I do different things with it. I love this hat. So have a hat with you if you're a lady. And it does not ruin my hairstyle. So that's my hat. And put it away. And if you're a man, absolutely grab one of these. Why not? So, you know, this is a hat for the men. So if you're a man, I'm not leaving you out. I'll share the article with you. Don't worry, Edward. I'll share the article with you once I'm done, because I have one actually. So if you're a man, have one of these with you. You don't want the hat, the sun hitting you too hard. And of course, that goes without saying that if you have a hat, you have one of these with you, don't you? So I always have my shades with me when I travel. Why? Because I want to look cool. I want to hide my tired eyes if it's been a very long flight. I want to hide my tired eyes. And How does this look with the sheds? Looks great, doesn't it? I look like I'm the Queen of England, don't I? Hey, thank you, thank you. Thank you, Edwards, thank you so much. So don't forget your sheds. I don't know why I bought these. They are also prescription sheds, and they are for sale. So they're good. Don't forget them. So that is what I have so far. Now this is beauty. Let's get to the beauty bit. There's something I always have. There are people who go to airports with high heels and they are clink clacking all over the place, pulling heavy luggage and all that. I don't. I wear these flat shoes. They've seen different airports. These shoes are amazing. They are comfortable. They are soft. They slip on and off my feet. When you're in airports, you're told to take your shoes off so you can go through security. They slip on and off my feet, and I usually have some nice socks on them. They are just fit slip-ons. That keeps my feet warm. I'm comfortable. I'm not tottering on in heels and falling over. No. And then I always have this with me when I in my hand luggage. Why is it there? Because if I'm going to a hot country, I have a pair of slippers with me. I have a pair of slip-ons, and I show my nice nails, which I have normally done with shellac or something or whatever. So I have a pair of I normally have this on, and I take this with me every single time. I'm the Queen of Africa. Yes, I am. Thank you. Thank you, Edwards. Now, here's the thing. I always take my diary with me. Why do I take my diary with me? Because I have a virtual assistant, a personal assistant who adds content to my online calendar, my Google calendar. If I make an appointment with you, or you've ever made an appointment with me, I always send you a link to my Calendly so you can make an appointment with me. I take this with me so I can transfer those to this in case technology fails me. This never fails me. So that goes with my Joy Journal when I'm traveling. There's something, this is personal to me, so it does not matter if you believe something else, feel free to. I take this with me every time. I believe I take Jesus with me. This is not an idol, it's just a sign that I believe that I am covered, I'm protected, I love my Lord, I love my God, and I take this with me on every trip I go on in my luggage. Let's get to the beauty side, because we have a lot. In addition to a pen, I told you I use my, again, if technology fails, I have this is a notepad that I take with me everywhere. It fits very comfortably in my bag, and I can take notes if technology has failed. Say Wi-Fi is not working on a flight, or my data is just not activated, or whatever, I take notes. Amen, Edwards. I take notes with me. Now let's get to the inner bits of my bag. The inner bit, the beauty. You don't know what that is? That is beautiful nails. Now I don't normally, I used to have the longest, sharpest, almost claws on my nails. I realized that every time I took those nails off, my nails were drier, they were brittle, they were breaking. Now this stuff is magic. What you do is you just rub it on your nail, on the cuticle, and it does magic for your nails. It keeps them strong. My nails never break anyhow. And if they do, it's because they've clicked on something hard. Hey Tina, welcome to this broadcast. This stuff is magic. Now I bought it very cheaply. I think it was like a pound in a shop called Aldi right here in the UK. I don't go anywhere without this stuff. And you get 3 refills in the little bottom bit. Those are the things that you use to apply on your nails, and they are great. So if you ever find it, check your boot store, check your drugstore, check your super drug. If you're in the UK, you'll find it. I don't go anywhere without something to put on my lips. This is called Baby Lips by Maybelline. Baby Lips, it's a lip color. It tastes amazing. When you get to your destination, you make your lips look better. It keeps them soft. By the way, I'm going to share with you something shocking. Before I go to any airport, I put on some lipstick and some eyeliner. I don't really put on much makeup myself. I'm not a makeup person, really. I just like to look amazing for you when I'm doing these live shows. So when I'm going to an airport, I put on some of this. You never know who you run into, a potential client, a potential student. You want to look great. Thank you, Karunji. How are you? How are you doing? But I go with my eye. That never leaves my bag. That never leaves. That's an eye pencil. I just line my under my eyes and that's it. And that's my lip color, which I use to soften my lips and make them look great. Now, here's the thing. As soon as I get on a flight, I wipe it all off because I want to get to where I'm going feeling fresh, looking fresh. So I always have wipes. But I'm jumping the gun. I'm jumping the gun. I take this with me. It's a chapstick. If you don't know what you need to use this for, I'm going to tell you today. A chapstick is great to have. It keeps your lips very well moisturized. It puts a layer on your lips so they don't dry out. Some countries are not dry. They are not hot, but they just dry you out. They are humid or something. I have a chapstick. If you've ever forgotten your face cream, your hand cream or whatever, the chapstick can do the job of what you've left behind until you buy some more. I never go anywhere without my charcoal. This is this you can buy from any, it's medicine or charcoal. What's it for? Several things. Tummy ache. Have you ever gone on a vacation or a holiday or on a trip or a business trip and you got a horrible tummy? This is going to be your savior. I get these from Boots. It's medicine or charcoal, 100 tablets. It clears out your stomach. Before a meal, I take one. Before a meal, anywhere I am in a foreign country, I take a tablet every day. It will keep your stomach balanced. It keeps your pH balance great. It keeps the good bacteria in your stomach doing their job. And you probably will not get holiday tummy if you have these with you, especially if you take before you go and if you take them after you go. Something I've forgotten to bring is not as a bottle of water. I never go anywhere without an empty bottle of water. An empty bottle, not a filled bottle, because you won't pass with a filled bottle of water through security. But if it's empty, you can go through with it. As soon as I go through security at the airport, I fill my bottle with water and I always refill. Once you get on a flight, they give you little cups the size of that thing to drink. It's not enough. You need to hydrate some more when you're on a flight. When you get where you're going, your skin will look great. You will not look puffed up and knackered and look like you're 20 years older. You look great if you hydrate some more when you're on a flight. I don't go anywhere without my odorless garlic tablets. Again, it's a personal thing. I get these from Super Drug, and they are great again for my skin. This is working from the inside out, and my skin glows because I take things that keep my skin great. In addition to eating lots of fruit, juicing it up, it's lots of vegetable. I definitely never go anywhere without my odorless garlic. Thank you, Joe. Thank you. I don't go anywhere without my hair cream. On a flight, now this is my hair cream. I don't promote the product, I just use it. It's called T444Z. It's a hairbrush product that's only sold through direct sales. If you want some and you're in Uganda, get in touch with me because I can bring you some. Anyhow, I'm very excited because I'm going somewhere exciting. I'm going home, I'm going on a dream trip, and I'm going on a long-awaited trip. I can't tell you how excited I am. So I'm almost done packing, and so I decided to do this as well today. So, hair cream, why? Because airplanes, they just dry you out. They have this cold, dry air that dries you out. It dries everything out. It dries your skin. It dries your hair. It dries everything. If you have your hair cream with you, and it should be under 100 mils, you'll never have dry hair when you get to your amazing destination. You're going to look the business. And I have a portion of that put in my carry-on bag. This is bicarbonate of soda. I never go to bed without drinking a little teaspoonful of this put in warm room temperature water. It's great for your pH balance. It alkalizes you. When your body is in an alkaline state, you will rarely get any of those diseases people suffer with today. So if you know what you are, what's good for you, make sure you have bicarbonate of soda, which comes from rock salt. Or if you don't have bicarbonate, have some rock salt. Just a little teaspoon of rock salt or bicarbonate in your water every night before you go to sleep. And every morning when you wake up, it's going to keep your body in an alkaline state. You don't have to pay a fortune for all these products people share with you to buy to keep your body in a state of great balance. Hey Laurie, how are you doing? Good afternoon. So bicarbonate of soda. Now I put a little bit of this in my little, I have little containers that I use there in my bag that I put things that are over 100 mils in. And I put a bit of that in there so that I can maintain my routine, because I have an evening routine and a morning routine. So where are we? And in the same breath, I always take tissues, just tissues. Hand tissues, hand towels, call them what you want. I make sure they are sealed because I don't like things flying around in my bag all over the place. These, you could use them to sneeze, you could use them to wipe a surface, you could use them for a lot of things. You need some tissues with you. The little tissues they give you in the airline, on a plane, they're like bits of fluff. They do nothing for me. Yeah, right, let's go on. I always have a spare purse. Why? Because bad things happen to good people. If you've packed all your beautiful purses, and this is a little designer purse that my son bought for me. He's only 13, but the boy is generous to a fault. Anywho, you're going for an event, and you're going to an event maybe the day you arrive wherever you're going, and your luggage, God forbid, delays or does not arrive with you, and you don't have a cool purse to carry. I'm a woman, so I have a purse. Have a purse in my bag. Right, next, tea tree oil. Tea tree oil, you don't know what this is for, I tell you, this stuff, the same thing that you have this with you, medicinal charcoal, is why I take with me essential tea tree oil. Now, I bought this again in a health store, in a super drug. You don't have to buy these essential oils from God knows who, people selling them for hundreds of dollars. This is 100% tea tree. It's very strong. You never, 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 ever use this directly on your skin without adding it to a base oil like maybe baby oil. I don't use baby oil much. It is petroleum. I use maybe olive oil, coconut oil, something to kind of dilute it. And then I can put it on my skin if I've got a rash, if I've got a heat rash, if I've got anything that's on my skin that's not right. I can even put it on a wound to seal it so no germs go in, because it's also an antibiotic disinfectant. You call it what you want. Next in my bag is a sweater, a cardigan. This is my papaya sweater. I've had it for yonks. It is nice. It is light. It folds to a very tight ball because I fold my things like that when I'm putting them in my carry-on, and I'll never be cold on a flight. Why? Because in addition to my sweater or cardigan, call it what you want, I have this. This, it looks like a blanket, right? I'll show you what it does. It doubles up as a poncho. It also doubles up as a blanket on the flight. I can put it on and look cool in Mexico. It doubles up as a poncho, and it also doubles up as a blanket. I can use it as a scarf. I can wrap it around my neck. I do a lot of things with this that are sexy and cool wherever I go. It looks heavy. It's very light. And I'll tell you what, I'm not very comfortable with airline blankets. I don't know when they last washed them. I don't know who last used it. And I don't know how clean it is. I don't want to cozy up to those things. So I have my own poncho, which is also like a blanket. And I take that with me everywhere. And whether it's a warm country or a cold country, there's always a cold spell at some point. I take that with me. And it does the job of keeping me warm on an airline. Now, I'll tell you what. Have you ever eaten airline food and you feel like you shouldn't have eaten it? Or look at it and you think, I'll be fine. But you have 8 more hours on that flight. Take a snack with you. Now, this is sugar-free shortbread biscuits. They are sugar-free. They're gluten-free. They're healthy. Well, I believe they are. I love them. I take this with me. I open the packet. There are 2 in this packet. I open it and I take one with me. I give one to Paul or to the kids. Depending on if I'm going alone, I'll just take one of the packs inside there with me. And I can chew on that and drink my water with it. You're not going to die by just eating a few biscuits and water And these days, airlines, they literally break everything apart. You in the old days, you used to buy your flight and you know you're going to get fed, watered, looked after, pampered, and even given a gift. These days, you have to buy the food, you have to buy the water, you even have to buy the blanket sometimes. Recently, I read a story about this guy who was flying from, I don't know, Chicago to Hawaii, and he asked for a blanket, and they told him that's $12. $12 for an airline blanket. No, I have my blanket, I have my sweater, I have my fuzzy, comfy socks. Soon as I get on a flight, I take my shoes off and I put these on. Now, these keep my feet warm and they keep my feet cozy, and I have several pairs of these. Every year I buy a new pair. They are absolutely amazing. I also have that. Now, you might wonder if it's a puppet. It's not a puppet. It's my face wash. I always have with me my facial soap. I always make sure it's 100 mils or less, and I take that with me on every single flight. Why? Because airlines, you're washing off your makeup, right? So I go into the bathroom, that little squeezy little cubbyhole that the airlines call a toilet, and I wash my face properly, and then I put on my face cream properly, so I don't have to use wipes that I don't know whether they'll work with my skin or not. Especially sometimes wipes may not happen. You may use them for years and then you use them and you land in a different country and the weather and the whatever chemical is in that wipe connects, and goodness gracious me, your face goes crazy. So take your usual soap, take your face wash, wash your face properly on a flight. Right, what's next? Change of clothes. We went to East Africa. I won't name which country. I'll name the flight. It was KLM. And they didn't bring our suitcases. For 4 days, we had to borrow clothes from friends. It was not nice. We had to buy a couple of t-shirts as well. So I always take a set of spare clothes with me, a top and a bottom, so I can have at least a smart set of clothes when I get to wherever I'm going now. Depending on whether I'm going to a hot country or a cold country, I'm going to a hot country very soon. I take a set of either warm clothing or cold clothing. Make sure you pack a set now, because we normally travel as a family. I put a set, also another set, in my husband's suitcase or my children's suitcase, so we each have at least 3 sets of clothes with us if bad things happen to good people, right? Okay, so let's get on to what other. I use this. I take these cotton wipes. I bought them from, I think, Superdrug. They're cotton wipes. They're little round cotton wipes. What are they for? They can be used for medicinal purposes, wiping a wound dry and washing, say your kid has fallen over, you fell over and you sprained yourself or whatever. You get one of these, you get water, you wipe it gently, and then you put on a base cream. Like I said, tea tree is great for that, and you're good to go. Or use them to wipe off that makeup off your face with your makeup remover, which I'll show you in a minute. I use micellar water. It's great. Just go buy it from Superdrug. It is cheap. It is not, you don't have to buy expensive stuff, but it's great, and it does not have any of those preservative chemical stuff for your face. What do I have? Hand cream. Like I said, on an aeroplane, on a flight, in those boxes in the sky, everything dries out. Your hair dries out, your skin dries out, your hands dry out, and your nails dry out. Now, I've shown you my nail food. I seal it in with hand cream. And this stuff is amazing. It's Atrixo. You can buy it again from a drugstore. Buy your Atrixo from a drugstore. By the way, I'm not affiliated to any of these things. I'm just showing you what I use. Buy Atrixo from a drugstore. And if you're in Africa, sometimes there's some things that are fake. Send for some if you have friends in Europe. Send for some. Okay, now this is something you might go, ooh, Julie, what's going on there? Now, I always carry this with me. A roller and a hairpin. Why? Because I'm a woman. Why not? When I get on the flight and I've washed my face and I put on my face cream and I have my facial spray, by the way. I spray my face intermittently. If I'm on a flight for longer than 4 hours, I'll spray my face and keep it clean, keep it fresh and cool on the flight. Now this, I roll my hair up, especially in the right up to the middle, so that it doesn't go flat when I get to where I'm going. I roll it up here, and then I am on my flight. After all, everybody's doing what they are. 8 hours, they switch off the lights as well, so do what you want to do. I roll up my hair so that when we get where we're going, it comes out in ringlets and looks as gorgeous as you can see right now. So those are rollers. I take with me my camera everywhere, and that is my selfie stick. I don't go anywhere without it. Now, I don't know what we used to do without our gadgets before the gadget digital era, but hey, these days you can shoot a video live wherever you are with your selfie. You hold it. You don't have to beg anybody to hold it for you. You just hold your selfie stick out and do your live show or take your picture, and you showcase your whatever beautiful Insta-worthy image you want. So don't forget your selfie stick. I bought this in Barcelona for £2. €2 in euros. I'm used to saying quid. €2 in Barcelona. You can't believe it. Amazing. Now, obviously, you can use your phone on your selfie stick. I love taking a proper camera. I travel with a proper camera because when I travel, I want to take shmazing images, high definition images. I like to take panoramic images. I like to take images that are amazing. So what do I take with me? My GoPro. Now, not everybody has a GoPro, but most people do have a camera. A lot of people have forgotten the use of these things to take images. They are not phones, computers, and everything rolled into one. All they do is they take amazing images and videos as well. So if you have a camera, take it with you. Don't just take your phone, because technology does fail. This thing won't fail you. You will take amazing images. By the way, it also has its own bits and bobs. As you can see, it has a stand with it. In this bag, there's a stand with it. I've got a card with it, and it's also chargeable. So that goes without saying that I've got a camera bag with me as well. And many times I just roll it over my head, and it's part of me. So it's not part of my baggage even. So it won't contribute to my weight. Because most airlines allow up to 12 kilograms in your hold all or carry-on luggage. So this won't contribute to that weight if I have anything to do with it. And most of these other things, the face wipes, my journals, they all fit in my handbag, and it's normally a rucksack. So I have a handbag that nobody's going to weigh, but let me tell you, some airlines have started weighing your handbag as well. And they tell you that your handbag and your hand luggage contribute to the total amount of your hand luggage weight. So be very careful. Check the small print of the airline that you're flying with so that you're not caught up in that kind of crackpot. So we talked about that. Now, let's take off that as well. I'm going to weigh my neck down. Let's talk about your beauty bag on an airline. Now, usually you are expected to carry a bag. Yeah, that's my Clarins bag. I bought it in, San Francisco. And it's clear, so it qualifies as a clear bag for purposes of travel. Now, it also has a proper zip. And I put in perfume under 100 mils. You want to get to where you're going smelling like the bae's nars, so you put in your perfume. Absolutely. So I have my perfume in there. I have another lip gloss, and this is an amazing piece of kit. Let me show you. It is an eye pencil, or a lip pencil. It is a lip gloss as well, and it is also, so your lips will look like, you know, kissable lips, and it also is a lipstick in one. How amazing is that? So we ladies have all kinds of knickknacks in our bags. Right, I have liquid facial wash. That's Clinique, and every time I go through any airport, I top up on my Clinique and Clarins and the kind of products I want. Now, you can buy whatever you want. You can go buy some whatever stuff you want in whichever country you go to, but one thing you must remember, whatever money you go with, take with you some money to buy some things for you. You deserve your money. You deserve your gift. Gift yourself some stuff. So I have this facial wash, and I use it every day as well, by the way. It's not just for travel. I have a bunch of this for my facial every day. So I have my facial wash in there. I have my serum. This is a facial serum. It's a facial oil. And like I said, airplanes are dry things. They dry you out. You can't believe it. So have something to rejuvenate your skin when you get where you're going. You're not going to look puffed up. You're not going to look like life has been so hard on you after an 8-hour flight. You are going to look great. Don't forget that. These are nasal drops. I swear by these. Honestly, airplanes are dirty, dirty, dirty things. You'll get dirty stuff in an airplane. So have that, because for some reason they blow on you cold air. You're sitting in a cool box for 8 hours. You're gonna get off that plane with your nose running. To stop that happening, that is the business. It is Vicks Fast Defense. Get it from any drugstore. I have it all the time. Some people may go, Vicks is yung, 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 yung. I don't care. I'm gonna live to be 100 and I'm looking after myself. Okay, I talked about the chapstick. I have my lip balm as well. This lip balm, oh, I wish you could smell it. It smells delicious. It smells like vanilla cake, crisp cookies. Ooh, lovely, lovely stuff. And I put it on my lips and they smell the business. Kissable, I'm telling you. Okay, so I have my body scrub with me. Why? Because like I said, you go pack your stuff in your luggage, check-in luggage, and your stuff doesn't get to where you're going. And guess what happens? You don't even have your nice stuff with you. So take some of that. This is 50 mils, so it is really, no, it's not even 50 mils, it's 30 mils. It's 30 mils, Clarins body scrub. I take that with me every time. Hey, Jennifer, how are you doing? I take that with me every time so that I can get my face scrub on wherever I am. If my stuff delays, if it doesn't, if I'm going for less than 7 days, I don't need more than that anyway. So I take that with me. And let me tell you, we talked about oil. You want this stuff, not just for travel. I'll just bring it closer to the camera so you can see what it is. It's called argan oil. It's a hair oil. It's a hair conditioner. You can use it as a hair treatment. You can put it in your hair, put on your cap and let it sit in for 20 minutes and then wash it out and give your hair a glow. Or you can just put it on your hair to give it a bit of a shine when you get where you're going so that it doesn't look Because here's the thing. I only put this on the scalp and on the edges of my hair. So I don't put it in the hair itself. This is for the scalp and the edges. It keeps my hair luscious, keeps my locks luscious, and it keeps it great. This is a tonic. It's a body treatment oil that I take with me. It's Clarins, and it is absolutely essential. I love it. Don't ask me why. It's for firming and toning. It firms and tones your skin. So your skin doesn't look like it's 60 years old when you're only 30. So you want to have that stuff with you. And now you don't have to buy the Clarins oil, but buy a body toning and firming oil. It's great for your skin. I won't tell you how old I am, but I'll tell you I look younger than most 30-year-olds. Okay, what else do I have? Spray. Perfume. It's the same. You're not going to spray yourself the same perfume everywhere. So I have a different scent with me. My son bought me that and I have that with me. This one is, what's this one? This is Trezor Midnight. And this one is just Love Spell. My son bought me that. Don't ask me. So there we go. Perfume. I have a hair kunchi thingy mijigi. I just use it to hold my hair up if I haven't taken my trusty hair rollers with me, so that my hair does not flatten when I'm lying back or putting my head back on the flight. I also take a scrunchie with me, a couple of hair scrunchies, which I can use to hold my hair up as well. So those are good. These are not for men unless you have a lot of hair with you. And then finally, what do I use? You remember I showed you my cotton buds? Well, this is what I use them for. This is Clinique makeup remover. I tell you what, we women think that if you just wash your face and you wash off the lipstick and you wash your eyes, it's enough. It isn't. This stuff stays on you. Especially when I wasn't looking after my skin, I got a bit darker under the eyes. Now, it's not too dark, but I can see it. So you make sure you remove all that makeup and remove it good, ladies. So buy a good makeup remover. You are worth it. So this is Clinique makeup remover. I think it's about like maybe 20 pounds in an airport. I only buy this stuff in airports as I come or go. I stock up on these things because when you go to the normal shops, they cost a lot more. So I stock up and I go through airports almost every other month or maybe every month. I'm not sure. I travel a lot. So cotton wipes, makeup remover in my holdall bag. So that was all in my clear bag. It's now empty. And then the stuff that you really need to remember. Remember I told you my nails, I love to make sure that they are nice and they do not pinch on me. I always have a nail file. Now, I don't take the metal nail file. I always take the a personal nail file with me, and it's just cardboard and it's a nail file. You need one of those. Buy one from Super Drug Boots or your local supermarket. I definitely always take deodorant with me. I mean, and that which doesn't show the color on the dress. Because you don't want to be a stink pot when you get where you're going. So in the same way, I have wipes, which I'm going to show you. You don't want to be a stink pot. No one wants to hang out with a stink pot or a smelly nelly. So eye drops. Eye drops, you need these. After 18 hours, I have actually a couple of different types of eye drops. After 18 hours on a flight, you are definitely going to want to freshen your eyes and get them clear and looking great. So get some eye drops before you travel anywhere. If you're going to go anywhere for more than 5 hours or you're going to go overnight, I guarantee you're going to have eyes like a demon. So have eye drops. They're going to be red. What else? I definitely always take a scarf with me. In addition, this is a pashmina. It's quite wide. It's quite large. It's a Louis Vuitton. And definitely I take that with me on every single flight, because you can just use it as a wrap around. You can put it around your neck so that you are not cold. Airlines flights are cold things, so you don't want to be cold on a flight. You have used your blanket to cover yourself, so your neck might be empty, so you have that with you. And guess what? I also have a neck pillow. Now it's up in, I've already packed it in my suitcase, ready for to go. I have a neck pillow that I used to just, so I don't fall asleep on some strange Bob's shoulder. So I have my own neck pillow, and I also use it as a kind of head rest if I'm lying down on the front of my seat. Snacks. I take healthy snacks. So these are real hand-cooked sweet chili crisps. Yum. Hey, take some snacks with you. Like I said, you don't want to get on a flight and there's crap food and you don't have any of your nice stuff. So take something with you. Take an empty bottle, fill it with water. Take some snacks with you. Share. And by the way, I take a couple so that I can share, I can offer to the passenger next to me. It's a great conversation starter. It's a great icebreaker so that you can then have a proper chat with somebody. 8 hours and you're not sleepy and you don't want to read a magazine. You don't want to edit your blog post or whatever. Talk to somebody, and the only way to talk to them is offer them a sealed packet of snack. Always have a first aid kit with you. I have a whole blog post on what's in a first aid kit, but I have aloe vera jelly soothing gels with me, and I have a soothing relief gel with me. I have a wet wipe with me in this bag, a couple of wet wipes with me. They just wipe if you get a sheen or whatever. Hey Sarah, thank you. You can wipe it with that. I have a full sewing kit with me, and it has never been stopped. It has never been stopped through any airport. So I have a full sewing kit with me in my first aid kit. I have a few earbuds with me, because you never know what could happen in your ear, especially on a flight. Oh my goodness. I also have some travel sweets in here. Oops. And I put some of those in here with me as well. So why? Because, you know, you want to make sure you're covered. This is your first aid kit anyway, isn't it? I have a piece of gauze with me, and I have one piece of band-aid with me. I have a toothpick, a flosser, and a toothpick with me in this amazing, it's like, what's her name? Nanny, whatever. It's like one of those, you know, it's got all kinds, and it's only a little bag. First aid, take that with you. You're traveling, you don't know where you're going, so make sure more eye drops. This is Paul's eye drop kit. And remember, we took our laptop, we took our phone or tablet. What else do you need? You need this stuff. It's a power bank. Now I bought this, it's called In Tempo. I bought it in Matalan here in the UK. I bought it for £9.99, and it has about 6 hours worth of charge on it. So I can charge my phone and tablet on it and still have some leftover, maybe keep me going for a whole day. And then when I get to where I get back to my accommodation, I recharge it ready for the next day. It's great. You'll never run out of charge with that power bank. So we live in a digital era. I'm a digital entrepreneur. I'm a digital nomad. I definitely go with my power bank. Let us go to the final bits. My bag is getting very empty right now. There are two things I never leave behind. My business cards. I have a business card holder with them. Hey, Sarah, how are you doing? Thank you, Tom. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. There's something I never leave behind when I travel. And that is my earbuds, my noise reduction earphones. Now, these are a godsend. I always make sure they are sealed when I get back home so I don't forget them. Some, you know, flights, there's a constant noise for 8, 9, 12 hours. You constant noise in your ears, block it out. Have your earphones. Have some neuro-linguistic programming running. Download it on your tablet. I'm doing the live on it. And let it play in your ears. It will send you to sleep pretty quickly. I also spray. I also have a spray that I use, but you don't want to be spraying stuff on a flight because some people are allergic. But I have a spray that I use to send me to sleep literally immediately because you want your beauty sleep. And 8, 9, 10 hours on a flight, unless it's a day flight and you've come, usually even if it's a day flight, you go to the airport for a flight at 6 o'clock and you woke up at 3 in the morning. So still, you want to take your stuff. So here are my goodies. Here's my goodie bag for the dry stuff, the things that are not wet. Because you, in order, when you're flying, whether short haul, long haul, you need to make sure that your stuff is in a clear bag for inspection at security. Otherwise, and don't put in anything over 100 mils. All those liquids I've shown you, they are all under 100 mils or under. So make sure that is your thing. So this is a bag that you can buy in any airline. It's an airport. It's a Clarins bag. It's a clear bag. And it's more solid than those little things that they give you out. What else do I take? A pair of extra socks. If I don't put these on, I'll put these on. They are like little shoes, but they are more comfy, and so your feet are not squashed. Why do I have these on instead of shoes? My feet get swollen. Some people do get edema on flights. You know, on a flight, your feet may get swollen. If you free them and they are like your normal, and you walk up and down several, and you twist your legs severally, whatever that word is, you won't have that problem on a flight. I can see you. Can you see me? Can you see me? Can you see me? Right, guys. Because I like looking out. Now, unless it's a night flight, even when it's a night flight, I like looking out with these binoculars and pulling the ground closer to me and seeing amazing things. I've seen amazing things with this. If you're going to an event, you're going to a concert, you're going to wherever, you're going to be miles away from the stage, these things, they are amazing. They bring everything right next to you. So you don't, hey, I love them. I have them everywhere I go. I have a pack of cards. Again, conversation starters. I always start a conversation with the person next to me if I'm not traveling with family. And we have a game of cards. It's several hours in the flight. Let's play. Hey, why not? Band-aids. I always have an extra set with me. This is a little thingy I bought in Boots. So I think it has eight band-aids in it. And it's great. It's really good to have these with you, especially if you travel with kids, because kids just fall over and hurt themselves. And then, like, mommy, mommy, yeah, 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 yeah. Get all that out of the way, clean with your stuff I've shown you, and put on a band-aid. A hair clip. I'm a woman. I clip my hair up different, and this is a sexy one, so I can do a different style with my hair and hold it up and go for a night out. Hey, so that's very important. What's that? Definitely, you want to rest. You want to block out the noise. And some people will switch on the light to read a book, and they are sat next to you, and you're on this 9-hour flight, and you want to sleep. Close them out, just put it over your eyes, and you're good to go. That job done. So you need that, and you don't want to. Some of those airline things, I bought this in a travel store. Why do you need this? Because sometimes they may give you one for free, but was it washed when it was last used? I'm not sure. After a flight I took from Orlando to Tampa, and I won't tell you, it was horrible. But you know, these flights, they don't necessarily clean everything. Do not forget your body cream. And this is a 50 mils cream, so it fits in, and it should have been in the liquids thing. It's a cream, so it's considered liquidy. Don't ask me. This is a Longchem Betty cream of all creams body lotion. When you get where you're going, you have your body lotion for your whole body, so you don't expect, you're not waiting on that one in the check-in luggage. You have your own body cream with you. I love this stuff. It smells great. It feels great. It's a really good cream. You have your own. I have my own. So, yeah. Now, this is for women. Like I said, you don't want to be a stinky pot. You don't want to be a smelly nelly. So, before you land, go on to the bathroom and change. You know, change these things. You know what these things are for. You know what they are for. Go and change your panty liner and put in a fresh one. If you've been on an hour on a flight for 8 hours, things are happening down there. You want to clean up, hey? Right, so go change. Go change it. Or wait till you get into the airport. Go again, go change. Put on a fresh one. And also have one in case your neighbor needs one on the flight. Offer them one, okay? Now, sanitizing wipes. Oh my goodness. And sanitizing hand gel. I have both. And they are also antiviral and antibacterial. Airplanes are dirty buggers. I'm telling you now. So have this shit with you. Because you want to clean and wipe everything before you settle down. Before you put food on that little tray, wipe it out. And before you touch anything, wipe it. Put this stuff on, lather it on your hands. When you go to the bathroom, after you've washed your hands, you've touched that door, wipe your hands. I tell you now, you want to be clean, right? You don't want to be a smelly nelly, neither do you want to catch something off that flight. It's very easy to catch something off a flight because somehow your whole body metabolism is thrown into helter-skelter. So you want to have this stuff with you. Antibacterial gel. It is antiviral, antibacterial, and it's called flu pack. I buy these from Boots. They're called flu pack. So they also prevent influenza, and they're antiviral, antibacterial, sanitizing wipes, and they're skin safe as well. So you can wipe your face with them as well. So definitely, I always have these with me. I have a pair of clean socks. If I'm going to a cold country, I have a pair of clean normal socks, and so that I can keep my feet warm. Toothbrush. I also have one of those tooth cleans that you put on your finger, and you buy them from Boots or Superdrug, and you just clean your teeth with them. Because, you know, believe it or not, that toothbrush has been in your thingy. Unless it's brand new, it's been in your bag since your last trip. What do you think's been growing on it? Germs. So this is a toothbrush that is for travel. Every time I buy a set of these, it's brand new. They are very cheap toothbrushes. Don't be using the same one after every trip. Throw away that one and get another one. Get a toothbrush. Clean your teeth. Nice clean breath. And guess what I also have with me that goes with the toothbrush? Toothpaste and extra strong. Extra strong throat lozenges. I also use these as like flight sweets. Because my goodness, my ears ache something terrible as flights are taking off or landing. So I throw a sweet in my mouth and then I throw in a chewing gum and I chew and yaw and yaw like crazy. My kids totally go crazy laughing at me when we are taking off or landing because I go to keep my, to balance the air and pressure in my ears. I don't know. Don't ask me. That's a pen as well. Pen. Always have a pen handy, an extra one, because if you're traveling with people, that handy pen will come in handy. As you can see, I've got sexy locks, and I need a brush, a hairbrush. Now, this comes out comfortably and brushes your hair nicely. So, nice hair brush sticking in my hair. Now, I bought this from Disney World. It's got Mickey. I bought it in Disney World directly from a Disney store. It's also got a mirror, so I comb my hair and then I check to see that everything's great. I check my makeup, everything's fantastic, and I just fold it back and put it away, and it folds away as a little fold up. So it's great to have. I always have a spare Ziploc. Once, if you're going to go and change your knickers, if you're in your periods, or you're a man, you need to change. You don't want to wear the same underwear for the next 14 hours. You mean you have a 24-hour flight. You gotta change that underwear. Have a Ziploc bag to put in all that stuff that you have used and you don't want to just throw in your suitcase. So when you know, Ziploc, I always have like 3-4 of those pair. Definitely, ladies, you know what that is, pair underwear. I'm not showing you what it is. And Finally, wipes, face wipes. Clear, simple, 5-in-1 cleansing facial wipes. These wipes, they moisturize, they remove eye makeup, they revitalize the skin, they have no alcohol, and you wanna keep your face and your skin. And you can use this for the whole body. You know, you wipe under your armpits, you wipe under, you know, there, and you wipe yourself clean and you keep clean. Now I'm saying things before I go, she's shocking. Yeah, you're a human being, you're an adult, you also have kids, you've got to show them. So you take your kids and you sell them, so wipe your armpits, wipe your whole body with this. Literally, we finish our park almost every airport. We wipe up and we clean up and we refresh and we spray, we put on deodorant, we put on some spray, we comb our hair, we redo our makeup, and we come out looking a million bucks. Right, guys, that's all. Bag is empty. Imagine all that stuff was in this one single bag. When I'm going away for less than 7 days, I just take a whole doll. That's it. I take a whole doll and a small hand luggage suitcase. So I use this as my handbag, and then I have my small hand luggage suitcase too. So everything I've got that I need goes in with me on the flight. It saves you having to go through waiting for your luggage to come through on a carousel, and it saves you having to worry about whether your luggage will arrive or not. You're going away for 7 days, not a whole year, so don't take your whole kitchen and bathroom with you. Although the way things are, you'd think I've taken the whole with me, but I usually travel with couple of kids and a husband. And you know, husbands are like our first children. They forget all kinds of stuff. We've got to remember things for them, so pack it all with them. One thing I've forgotten to share with you, a jacket. I always take a warm jacket with me with several pockets. This jacket is a bag of old. It's got two pockets inside, outside, two pockets inside, a phone pocket. It's got a hood in case I want to hide away from the next person. They are like talking 101 things and I just want to sleep. I just put my hood up, put in my earbuds, block them out and sleep. Probably being rude, but hey, you have 8-9 hours, you didn't sleep all night, and this person is talking for England. You just close them out, spray your spray under there, and just... So guys, I hope I've given you something amazing. The reason I travel a lot is because I'm part of a travel community, a global community, a community of amazing entrepreneurs, amazing life, people who love life, people who love to see the world and to dominate and rule. And if you want to know more about that, I'm willing to share with you. Just drop a one below and I'll come in your inbox and we'll have a chat. Or come into my inbox, let's talk about it. I will leave a link above this video with a whole list of all the things you can ever need to pack wherever you're going, whether long haul, short haul, hold on, carry on luggage, whatever. I have a whole resource that I wrote. If you want to learn how I travel and enjoy this world, head on to pkjulesworld.com/fun. I'll leave the link above this video and it will be the pinned comment in the comments below. If you're watching from YouTube, thank you. Subscribe. Don't forget to subscribe. And until the next video, rise and shine to your awesome destiny. You know you want to.